Welcome back to Animal X. Pets are renowned for their extrasensory powers that can help save lives, but how do they foretell impending tragedy? New evidence suggests we have a lot to learn from our furry friends, especially when it comes to one particular natural disaster.
Earthquakes. For centuries, scientists have failed in their efforts to predict and to minimize the devastation they can cause. But should they be looking to nature and not machines for answers? In the second part of our special report, Animal X investigates the evidence that pets can save our lives by picking up signs of an impending earthquake. We went to the relatively safe environment of Northwest London to meet a man who's conducted controversial research on earthquake-predicting pets. Dr. Rupert Sheldrake is a former researcher at Cambridge University. He's been gathering anecdotal evidence of pets foretelling quakes. He believes that these phenomena are nothing new as far as pet owners are concerned.
All over the world, throughout recorded history, there have been stories of animals reacting in advance before an earthquake happened. And many people throughout the ages have taken these signs as warnings. And in fact, there are cases where people's lives have been saved by paying attention to these animal warnings.
Anna Riel, a journalist working in New York, is living proof of that scenario. In fact, her entire family owe their lives to a dog named Che. In 1972, they survived this. Nicaragua's worst earthquake, which hit the capital, Managua. Nearly 10,000 people died, 20,000 were injured, and over half the city's 400,000 population lost their homes. No one knew it was coming. Or did they? Anna says up to 3 days before the quake, the family's dog, Che, began acting totally out of character. Luckily, her mother saw it as a sign.
The dog was really upset and doing crazy things like biting the furniture, pushing you, you know, running in between your legs and just doing crazy things all day. And then my mom said, something is going to happen. The dog is upset. It's telling me something.
Anna says the night before the quake, her mother ordered everybody to move furniture against the walls to create a clear escape route through the house. She also left the front door wide open and told Che to stay there. The family then went to bed. Disaster was only hours away.
About midnight, we had a quake. That was bad, but it wasn't that bad. And then the dog kept running back and forth from the door to the rooms, just like alerting everybody to get up and go. So we all got out of the house just to wait to see what happened next. And 15 minutes later, there was a huge quake that destroyed the whole city. That was the biggest earthquake in Nicaragua. From now on, I believe, you know, when an animal is upset that lives with you, you better listen to it because it's telling you something, you know? And it's really unusual, but I think they're really psychic.
Dr. Sheldrake says it's these type of experiences that scientists can learn from. He says they must look beyond their conventional theories and investigate the unexplained powers of pets.
If we could find out how they do it, we might be able to develop machines that do it better. Or if it's something that machines can't do, then we'd better find ways of finding from the animals in more effective ways.
Deep in the woods in Santa Cruz, California, researcher David Brown has been helping Dr. Sheldrake with his investigative work into psychic pets.
Well, I primarily heard it in dogs, cats, horses, are the most common. It's been reported, though, in fish and birds, we hear it. It's even been reported in insects. Fish have been known to leap out of the water prior to an earthquake in some cases.
David says a common scenario before a quake is for wild animals to head out of their natural environment into the city and for domestic pets to take their place.
So it seems like pets become more wild and wild animals become more tame. It's one of the patterns that we've noticed in the research.
It's claimed that even this pet mouse stinker is capable of predicting earthquakes. Its owner, Marilyn Gillam, supports the theory that tame animals take on a wild personality before a tremor.
He'd grab the food out of my hand and he would squeak, and it would be like feeding a wild mouse. Sometimes I would even wait, like I would feed him, and he would squeak, grab the food, and I'd go, there's going to be an earthquake. And then I'd look in the paper, and there'd be nothing. And then I'd go, well, you know, it's, and then I hadn't felt any earthquake. And then 2 days would go by, and still he's acting like that, and there wouldn't be an earthquake. And then, sure enough, the third day, there would be, you know, something in the paper.
An extraordinary tale? Well, there's more. Dr. Sheldrake claims to have gathered reports from people in England whose pets have made some startling predictions during times of war.
In the Second World War, there were many cases of dogs or cats giving warnings of air raids long before the official warning sirens went off. Some of these warnings occurred when planes would have been taking off in Germany, and even if they could hear a plane taking off in Germany, they wouldn't necessarily have known it was coming to England or to their part of England. And also, in some cases, these warnings continued when the Germans were using V-2 rockets, which are supersonic rockets, where the rocket would arrive before the sound.
So how are pets able to predict earthquakes, their owners' return, and air raids? Dr. Sheldrake and his team of researchers are looking at various theories, including this one.
Around 15% of the Earth's crust is composed of quartz crystal, and in some places it's actually as high as 55%. And you know, if you put actually pressure on quartz crystal, it actually generates an electrical charge, and it creates airborne electrical particles. And it could be that what the animals are picking up on are these airborne electrical particles, and it could somehow be affecting their nervous system.
It's a plausible answer for pet owner Jeanne Brown. Her cat, Blossom, has reacted strangely many a time before a quake. Not so extraordinary, perhaps, but in this case, Blossom is deaf.
Well, as you can see, even in her old age, she's always actually been quite a peaceful, mellow little cat. And all of a sudden, she'll just jump up and run into the other room as if she's chasing something. She'll dart around the house or the yard, wherever she'll be, with a really strange behavior. It's just unlike her. I've observed it so many times now that it's... I'm accustomed to it. I don't jump up as often anymore. It's kind of exciting, actually. Oh, yes, it's an earthquake. I prepare myself. What will I do next? Pick up Blossom, go to the nearest doorway.
Dr. Sheldrake would like to see a list published which shows signs to look for in animals that indicate a tremor is on the way. As well, he would like a telephone hotline set up based on early earthquake warning signs in pets.
In the United States, it could be 1-800-PET-QUAKE or something, some number that you'd ring, an easy to remember number that you ring if your pet's showing these signs. You could then have a central place where these calls come in, and computers could analyze the incoming calls by district and area from the phone numbers. And if there was a sudden surge of calls from one particular region, this would suggest that there could be an imminent earthquake.
Perhaps in time, scientists will decide to take advantage of animals' extraordinary extrasensory powers.
It's said there are stranger things in heaven and earth than we can think of. You've just seen some of them on Animal X.